back to business. And for a guy in the middle of a season, what's this week been like? You know, having to just kind of pause and, you know, focus on, you know, one of the reasons that you're here at the University of Wisconsin in the first place.
Yeah, it's definitely a different mind shift. You know, having to go back to school and worry about that academics and not really much basketball stuff. I think it's nice just to have a little bit of a shift away from basketball, get your mind away from it, and now everybody's hungry and ready to go again and get ready for Cal.
What was your final exam schedule like? And at this stage in your career, is it as heavy as maybe some of the other guys?
Mine was actually really nice. I'm in grad school, so I didn't have any finals. Mine were just last-minute papers that I had to take care of. So I didn't do too bad of a job procrastinating, so I took care of it earlier.
Sounds like, Sam, then you're able to, you know, maybe catch up on a little rest. Is that kind of the big thing this time of year, too?
Rest and rehab and just get the body right before we get into the Big Ten season and then the heavy load of our schedule.
Is this the first semester of grad school for you, or have you been in now, too?
Yeah, it's the first semester of my grad school program.
And is it going well? I mean, is this time of year as stressful as undergrad was?
Yeah, no, I really like it. It's a lot of interesting stuff, and I don't think it's as stressful. I think they expect a lot more out of you, and it's a lot more kind of individual work and group work. So it's a little bit of both, but I think it's a lot more manageable than undergrad was for me personally.
The challenge of getting back on the bike in terms of playing basketball games again is you're going on one of your more extended trips next to the tournament down in the Bahamas, and you're playing a really good team. I guess, what are your thoughts about the task of Cal, both in terms of getting there and then playing against a high-caliber team?
Yeah, I mean, we're excited for it. They're a very talented team. You know, they had a very good tournament in New York, unfortunately fell short against Texas, but I think they're very capable. They're going to be really good in the Pac-12, and we're excited to go out there and play them.
The way this team is gelled and what you've learned from the Duke game, I guess, and the fact that you're approaching Big Ten play, you know, what are the final pieces of the puzzle you'd like to see snapped into place here these last couple non-conference games before you set sights on that next goal?
Sure, I think just gelling together the last couple pieces. You know, in the Duke game, we learned a lot about ourselves individually and as a team, and I think over this next course of 10-15 games, you know, we want to try and put things together and really make things gel better even than they were before, defensively, offensively. So we're playing our best basketball at the end of the year.
Last year, you were the guy that kind of, you know, in that last half of the season really, you know, emerged, stepped forward. I think a lot of people are looking at maybe a guy like Vito as being that guy this year. Do you see Vito making those strides? Do you think he's a guy that we're going to hear a lot from the second half of the year?
Sure. Yeah, Vito's worked hard in the offseason. I think it's just whoever takes advantage of the opportunity. Everybody's going to have their moment, and it's up to the person to see what they do with it.
And I hate to ask holiday questions now that you know, and take your mind off the game at hand, but Christmas comes up right after Cal. What's that holiday season like in your family, and are you looking forward to, you know, a few days at home with your family?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm actually going Christmas shopping after this right now.
Really?
Yep. Go take care of that for my parents. But, I love Christmas time. The one thing I love to do is go down to the city of Chicago and just walk around with my parents, see the lights and stuff like that. So there's no better feeling for that, just to be home for that. But I'm excited just to get away from here for a little bit for 3 days because we don't get the opportunity to go home for a while. So I'm going to definitely cherish that and take advantage of it.
So the Miracle Mile was a big part of your childhood, getting downtown?
Yep, absolutely. Seeing Mickey light up the trees with my dad on my dad's back. So I'm
really?
Yeah, we did that every year. My mom would be running around videotaping us.
Wow.
Yep.
And anything else about being a Chicago native that, in terms of traditions downtown there that, you know, it seems like the bigger cities have the skate rinks and all that. Not sure a guy your size would be on skates, but anything like that?
Well, I think just the tradition of watching basketball. We always woke up at 10:30, 11 o'clock, open to presents, and then right to catch the first game, the noon game on ABC. Unfortunately, the Bulls over the last couple of years haven't been so hot, but now that they're obviously at the top in the East, they're going to be playing on Christmas Day, so
sure.
We'll be going to the game on Wednesday or Thursday, whatever
really?
It is. Yeah,
wow.
So it'll be nice to go to that game.
Yeah,
and then also any childhood memories of memorable Christmases? You know, Sam talked about memorable ornament from his grandpa, but any present that will go down in Duquesne history as being the one that was a favorite or a memorable one?
That's a great question. I probably have to say my Steve Nash jersey. My dad got me a signed Steve Nash jersey for Christmas. I think it was 4 or 5 years ago, and I think that's probably my best one. I've been a huge Steve Nash fan ever since I was little, watching him play, and that's kind of why I wear number 13. So,
gotcha.
So that's probably my best gift I've gotten.
So you more from his jersey than yours now.
Yep,
huh?
Exactly.
Outstanding. Well, do they have a Merry Christmas?
You too. Thank you.
Thank you.